Good evening, everyone. Live from the Butcher Center in Shepherdstown, West Virginia, I'm Avery Newport, and this is Shepherd Rams Basketball. Tonight, the Rams play their third game in 5 days as they host the struggling East Stroudsburg Warriors. Shepherd's record currently stands at 13-3 with a 7-3 PSAC record, while East Stroudsburg looks to get their first win in conference, sitting at 1-14 and 0-12 in the PSAC. After the conclusion of this game, the Shepherd men's team will face off against ESU, with the Rams coming in at 7-8 and 3-6 in conference, and the Warriors at 10-5, 8-3 in conference, and on a four-game winning streak. Well, thank you so much for tuning in to this evening's doubleheader of Shepherd Ram basketball here at the Butcher Center, everybody. My name is Avery Newport. So glad to have you with us here on the PSAC Sports Digital Network. We see will drive baseline, gets rejected, and a save by Abby Beeman. Beautiful defensive sequence there. And Marley McLaughlin has the rock now. Beautiful bounce pass in the lane. 2 points for Sydney Clayton. Leah Pishock is also into the game now for ESU. Lobs the inbound in. Beeman with 4 seconds. Step back three is up and rattles in. Right before the first quarter buzzer sounds. Beautiful play there for the Rams. Abby Beeman receives the handoff and launches a deep three that goes through. 28-13 is our score at the end of the first quarter here at the Butcher Center. We'll get back to you with some more Ram basketball action here on the PSAC Sports Digital Network. Can't get the bounce there. Maddie White with the rebound. So no three-point play. There's a great pass down court and an easy layup right at the basket for Jordan Smith. Mackenzie Free set it up with a nice outlet pass and an assist for number 11. Pass into the corner. Quarter tries a corner three and knocks it down. Claire Quarter, the junior guard, hits from the deep corner. 20-point lead for Shepherd here. Marley Adams dribbles around traffic. A nice pump fake from Weesey, who lines up a three and gets it to go. Ryan Weesey gets this game back down to single digits. 52-43 now our score. Miner passes off the hands of White. Another turnover for Shepherd. Here comes Pishock the other way. Weesey tries another three. She got it! And just like that, it's a 52-46 ball game. Jenna Eckleberry needs a timeout, and she calls it right here. An outstanding third quarter for this ESU Warrior team. The Rams are reeling here as a timeout called by head coach Jenna Eckleberry. 52-46 now our score. 3.5 minutes to play in the ball game. The Rams in a very vulnerable position here, only up by six. Weesey thought about a three, another pump fake there. Vogel, who hit a corner three a moment ago, hits another here. And they will say it is a three-pointer. Now just a three-point lead for the Rams. And what was a 20-point lead earlier in the first half has almost completely evaporated. Justin Paz has the basketball, passes near side to Troy Jones. Stevens nearly knocks it away. Pass cross court back to Paz, 15 on the shot clock. Paz gets it again, another deep three is up and good for Justin Paz. He's hit a couple of those NBA range threes this evening. And Paz increases the ESU lead to 7. Back to Stevens. Stevens drives into the paint, looking to pass, kicks it out. Pump fake from John Preston, gives himself some room, and there's a lot of room between that shot and the basket there. There's an air ball. Paz guarded by Preston, gets around a screen. Passes to Troy Jones, 3 seconds on the shot clock. They get it out to Rodriguez, who hits the corner three. And that might just be the dagger here with 1.5 minutes to play.